Today we're going to talk about the stepper driver for the DRV8825. And I need to review a couple of quick things here for you. We have our X stepper port, our Y stepper port, our Z stepper port, our E0 stepper port, our E1 stepper port, and our E2 stepper port. Now, in order to use the DRV8825, we can use a NEMA 17, and we have two connectors. We have our DuPont connector here, and we also have our screw down connector, which we can screw in the actual ports for each one of the wires. Now, the DRV8825, you have to have all of your jumpers set to on to use the greater stepping capacity of 32 steps rather than the 16 steps that occurs on the A4988. In order to do that though, the jumpers have to be all on. So I believe on is in the down position here. So in a moment, I'll show you how the DRV8825 looks on the underside and how we figure out how to connect it. Here's the underside of the DRV8825, and I'm going to point out a couple of landmarks. We have our ground pin right here, then we have our direction pin, our enable pin, and our other ground. The ground pin is going to be relevant for how we're going to set it up in a moment. So in a second, I'm going to show you what the PCB looks like from the diagram for the Roomba 3D printer board. Okay, what we have here is the Roomba PCB layout, and we need to find where the ground is on the X stepper ports. So I'm going to zoom in here so you can see what's going on. So what we have here is the tracings on the board for the printed circuit board. And if you look real close here, you've got this line here, line here, line here, and line here. This is the design for a ground pin, and we have another one over here. So now we know where the two grounds are. We can hook up our DRV8825. Okay, now that we know where the ground pins are, we can locate it on our board. So for our stepper driver board, it's right here, so we're going to rotate it over. And we know our other ground is here, so we're going to line these up, apply a little bit of thumb pressure, and push it in. Now we're going to connect the DuPont connector right over here for the stepper motor. And in a moment, we'll load the Marlin firmware, but first I'll show you how to connect the USB. So you're going to take the small side of your USB and connect it over to here. And you're going to take the other end and connect it to your computer's USB port, and you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to open up the Marlin-bugfix-1.1.9 folder. Then we're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Next, we're going to open up the boards file. In the boards.h, we're going to do a search on Roomba, and we're going to copy board_Roomba. Then we're going to close out of this file. Then we're going to press M on the keyboard, and we're going to open up the marlin.ino file. Okay, now we're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And what we're going to do is we're going to highlight board_ramps_14_EFB. And we're going to paste what we copied. So now we have board_Roomba. Okay, the next thing that we're going to search on is access steps, and press find. And what we have here is default access steps per unit. And right now it's defaulted to 80, 80, 4,000, and 500 for X, Y, Z, and the first extruder. So because this is a DRV 8825, we need to change 80 to 160 because it's double the steps of an A4988. The next thing that we have to do is search on the DRV 8825. And as you can see down here, we have to actually tell it what the default drivers are because it'll assume that an unspecified driver is an A4988. So we're going to put in here DRV8825. In order for it to be seen, because it's commented out, we have to remove the comment for the X driver. And then the next thing that we want to do is we want to check to make sure we have the right board selected, which is the Mega 2560, which is correct, and that we have our COM port selected, which we do. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to compile and upload with the upload button. And in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we're going to test it. Okay, between loading the firmware from Marlin, I added the power supply over here. Now it's not energized at the moment, but does have 5 volts running through it, so you don't want to touch the board when it's energized. And I also added an end stop switch for the x-axis so that we can test it. So I'm going to plug it in now, and in a moment I'll show you in Pronterface how it's going to work. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so I'm going to open up Pronterface. I'm going to connect to the Roomba board. Now the first thing that you want to do is you want to home the x-axis and actuate the end stop. So I'm going to home it while holding it with my finger. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to move it ahead by 10 millimeters and see what happens. So it moves ahead by 10. Now let's go back by 10. Now it moves back by 10. Let's try 100. Okay, and then back by 100. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.